हेलो फोक्स, वेलकम टू द जेवर विस्टेड यूट्यूब चैनल।
कोर्स ऑफ जावास्क्रिप्ट, यू विल लर्न जावास्क्रिप्ट फ्रॉम स्टार्ट टू एंड। दिस इज जस्ट अ क्विक इंट्रो टू जावास्क्रिप्ट एंड अ रोड मैप टू डेवलपमेंट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टू अवर कोर्स। सो मेक श्योर डैट यू हैव सब्सक्राइब माय यूट्यूब चैनल सो यू कैन गेट ऑल द न्यू वीडियोज फॉर ऑल द न्यू कोर्स डैट आई विल अपलोड माई यूट्यूब चैनल। सो बिफोर जावास्क्रिप्ट, वट यू शुड हैव टू नो बिफोर जावास्क्रिप्ट एंड वाई जावास्क्रिप्ट इज इम्पोर्टेंट। सो if you want to become a full stack developer or you want to become a front end developer, you must have to know the concept of html and css. Why html and css? Because html and css are the fundamental of web development or front end development. You have to know html codes, you have to know that how to write html codes and how to write CSS on HTML. After that you can start your JS journey or JS career or whatever you can say to yourself, JS developer or a full stack developer. So you have to know HTML and CSS before JavaScript. If you start JavaScript directly, so you are not going to get any benefit from JavaScript. So first of all, I would like to recommend that if you want to become a front-end developer or a full-stack developer, then you must have to know the concepts of HTML and CSS. What is JavaScript language? JavaScript is a programming language, not like HTML and CSS. JavaScript is a pure programming language. It is a client scripting language. Now what is a programming language? Like HTML is a hypertext markup language and JavaScript is a programming language. It is also a client scripting language. It is used to create dynamic websites and it is also used to add GUI means graphical user interface effects to make websites more beautiful. And now let's know the difference of HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Then you can differentiate between HTML, CSS and JavaScript. So HTML is the skeleton of the body. Let's say you have a car, you have a skeleton of the car. So we have a body of a car and HTML is just skeleton on the body of the body. Okay, now JavaScript is the engine of the body. HTML is the skeleton. JavaScript is the engine on the body, and after that skeleton and the engine, so that our body can operate some function. And after the both things, CSS is the designing part. So how our car look like, and after applying CSS on our model or our body, our car will be more beautiful than before. So this is the basic concept of HTML, CSS and JavaScript. JavaScript is the engine on the body or engine of the body, so that the body can operate some functions. So guys, I may hope that you can understand difference between HTML and CSS and JavaScript. So now let's start our next part of the course. So hello guys, now we are going to install our VS Code and going to set up VS Code for JavaScript, so that we can write our JavaScript course. So first of all, you have to set up VS Code, and I just opened my browser and going to install VS Code. Simply type VS Code, and after that you will see a official website of Visual Studio Code. Simply code.visualstudio.com, and after this click on this website. You will see a website and simply you can download it from here. So the downloading process is very easy and installation process is very easy. And after that, what you have to do is that you will see a pop-up window like this after installing the VS Code. I already told how to install in HTML and CSS course. Simply click on the download for Windows and you will get a download option here in the bottom, or you will get, if you are using IDM, you will get in the IDM section. Here you can see I just got a download option. I'm just going to pause it because I do not want to install it again. So here you can see you have to open a new folder. Just click on open folder, and after that you can choose your folder. I'm just going to choose JavaScript here and select JavaScript. Okay, fine. Now what you have to do, you have to make two files here, not only one, you have to make two files here, index.js, index.js and index.html. That's good. Okay, now first of all, there are two methods so that we can use in HTML to connect our HTML with JS. Okay, first of all, we have to write our heading files. Just press shift and one exclamation mark, you will see emit abbreviation, just click on it, and after that you have to write here. Now we are going to connect our HTML to CSS, and internally or externally, this is internally, simply you have to write script, and okay, script here, and just close it, and you will get this one. Okay, now you have to write document dot write, and here we are going to write our hello world program. Hello world, why hello world? Because hello world is a tradition to write in any programming language. It is a kind of tradition of programming. So I'm just going to write hello world, and just press right click and click on format document. It will make your document format, and it will look more beautiful than before. Okay, now I'm going to open and going to show you our program. Here you can see hello world. We write hello world not in HTML, in JavaScript. Here you can see in JavaScript. This is a script part, and we use in HTML. After that, if you want to write externally like this in this part, so what you have to do? So first of all, I'm just going to copy pasting it, control x, and I will control v here. Okay, now let's see what you see. A control r heading, nothing is here because we have not connected our HTML to CSS. Now how is this possible? Just write script src, and you have to write the name of your file, js file. So the name of my js file is index.js, so I will write index.js, fine. Okay, now our HTML is connected to JS. Now let's see the output, and here you can see, okay, I'm refreshing it again, and here you can see this is our output, and you can see we write our first program in JS. So guys, now we are going to learn the concept of comments and statement in JavaScript. So you guys can also use comments in your program. So what are comments? So let me here you can see, I'm just going to comment here, control slash. Okay, I'm just going to tell you about comments. There are two types of comments in JS. Okay, there are two types of comments, like single line or multiple line. The first one is single line comment, and the second one is multiple line comment. Fine. Okay, the spelling of multiple is wrong. Okay, just leave it as it. So what is single line comment? As you can see, this is just a single line, and how to write? Just control slash, and this will be single line. Otherwise you can manually type /, and you will see this is a comment, or you can use control slash and it will automatically be commented. Okay, now this is a single line comment. Okay, let me show you. Let me write something, a document dot write, and checking comments. Fine. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I will see in the output section, and I just refresh this, and you can see checking comments. We are just checking our comments, is it working? Yes, it's working. So now what I'm going to do, I will write also a multiple line comment. How to write multiple line comments? Simply slash, and after press shift and the asterisk. Okay, this is a multiple line comment. So So you guys don't have need to pressing slash slash in every line. It will look more beautiful, like multiple line looks more beautiful if you have to write something. So why comments are used? If for example I have to give codes to you guys, so you guys can also understand from my code. So I will write here this is a way to print in JS. Now you guys can know that this is a way to print in JS by using document.write, and in double quotation you can write anything you want to print. So this is the benefit of the comments. So what we are going to do now, we are going to learn the concept of, let me zoom so you guys can see it clearly. Okay, now I am just going to teach you about statements in Python. Oh, so statement in JS. So I apologize for this. Statement in JavaScript. Okay. First of all, I am just going to write a variable a and semicolon, variable b, semicolon, variable c, semicolon, and after that I just assigned three variables, and I'm just going to giving the values a is equal to 10, a is equal to 1000 and b is equal to 2000. Fine. And now c is equal to a plus b and semicolon. Now let's check the output. Is our answer right? Is it working? No, it's not working because we have not used any print statement, like document dot write, and after that you have to write c here, and it will print your answer here. You can see 3000, or I think you can also use here a double quotation, like the answer is okay. Let me just control slash this. Okay, now the answer is c, and a comma here and a colon. Let me check it out, and you can see here the answer is 3000. So this is the statement, and variable let me comment here variables, and this is statement. And first of all, I declare variables, declaring variables. You guys can also declare in one line, just like variable a, variable b, variable c. So let me show you, the answer is same, nothing is gonna change. So this is also a way, I was just teaching you a simple way. So this is another short way to declare your variables, and here I declare variables, and here you assign values, and here sum, and this is print statement. So now you guys know the benefit of comments, and we also learned one more thing, and is that statement in JavaScript. So now we are going to learn the concept of console in JavaScript. So what I'm going to do, I will make a new file here. Even you can use the same file, but I do not want to make you guys confused, so I will use a new file here, or I will make a new file here and I'm going to name it as console.js, and I will also make a new file of HTML, console.html. fine, we will use the same method here, and after that I'm going to connect my HTML with JavaScript. Here you have to write the name of your HTML file, console.js, and after that I'm just going to write my JS here. I will make a new space here. Okay, now how to write console? What is console? Okay, let me show you here. Here is my console file. Okay, console file means you just press click and right click and on mouse and just click on inspect, and after that you will see here a console file. Everything that you will see here is known as console. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I will make some changes in our JS code. So I will write here console.log and checking console, or you can write anything that you want. Even you can write hello world program in console. Okay, let me reload this. You will see nothing here. You just have to click right click on mouse and click on this inspect, and after that you have to go into console section. Click on this console and here you can see one message mean checking console and it's working fine. After that, what I'm going to do, I will make some changes in the console.log and I will write hello world program, hello world in JS. Fine. After that, let me show is it working. Okay, let me refresh and here you can see hello world in JS. Fine. After that, I will also teach you and one other console.var. What is console.var? This is warning in console. This is warning in console. This is warning. Fine. And let me see, is it working? Yeah, you can see this is a yellow caution and you can see this is warning. And after that I will also show you one other console, and console name is console.error, and this is an error in console. So this is the concept of console in JS, and let me reload this, and here you can see the red one is the error and the yellow one is the warning and the blue one is the simple message or a user message. Here you can see hello world in JavaScript, this is warning and this is an error in console. Okay, now one more thing is that alert function or alert in JS. So how we use alert? You can also use in the answer like this index.js, and after that you can use, let me comment this first, control slash, and after that you can use alert, write alert, and here you can write the answer is C, a colon, a comma, and C. Okay, let me check. We have to open index here, and you can see here the answer is C is not showing correctly. The answer is C. Okay, nothing showing here. The answer is C. Okay, let me check it again. Control R. Okay, let me remove the quotation in the alert, and let me write C only, and let's check its output again. And I will refresh this. Control R, and here you can see its answer is 3000, and this is alert function in JS. And let me also right here console dot, not console dot, sorry for that, alert, simply write alert, and this is the alert. Okay, now let's check its output, and this is console, and here you can see this is the alert. Okay, now fine. Here you can also write something else in the home page, like document dot write. After the alert, you are seeing this. Okay, now let's reload this, and this is the alert, and after the alert you are seeing this. So this is the basic concept of console, console.log, console.warn, console.error, and also alert in JS. Okay, we have learned a lot of things in JavaScript. Now what we are going to do, we are going to learn the concept of data types in JavaScript. So what is data types? Let me show you in this. So I will make a new file here, data types.js, and you can also use the same file like index or anything you want to use. And I will also make a new file here of HTML data type.html. okay, now we will use the same process here, and after here we have to connect our, let me remove this from the notifications and console, and this is index console.html. okay, fine, this is data type and this is data type html. okay, now we are going to connect our html with JavaScript. I'm just repeating this process again and again so you guys can understand how to write html and how to write js. Now script src, write the name of the js file. My js file name is data type dot js. now it's connected to js. now what we are going to do, we are going to learn data types in html js. So let me comment here, and data types in JavaScript, data types in js, fine. And now what are data types? Data types mean, okay, integer, float and string, and also one more in js is boolean. These are basic data types for a beginner, and these are the basic data types for a beginner. If you are a beginner, you have to learn this kind these data types. You must have to learn these data types so you can write your codes in js. So for example, variable a is equal to 5 55 or 99 99. And what is 99 99 99? Is an integer data type. And why 99 99? Means integer. You don't have to declare, you don't have to mention as like in C++ that this is an integer data type, integer x, not like this. You just have to write variable a is equal to 99 99 is integer. JavaScript knows itself that it is an integer data type. And variable b is equal to my YouTube channel JavaScript, and you have to write in single quotation, in double quotation, that JavaScript, because this is an integer data type, string data type. And here you have to write string data type, fine. And variable c is equal to float data type. What is float? Float means indoors. 99.3, this is float. And I just missed a semicolon here. Don't miss a semicolon, otherwise if you miss, don't worry, JavaScript forgive if you miss Java semicolon in the JavaScript, but you have to write semicolon in the end of a line, so it will give you more practice, so you will learn more in JavaScript. So now what I'm going to do, I will make a comment here that this is float in JavaScript js, simply js. okay, now variable d is equal to true, and semicolon. And after that, what I'm going to, I will show you output, what is data.js. so okay, now I will open data types, and you will see nothing here because we have not print it. So you can use document.write, or you even can also print in console. Let me show you both. First of all, we use document method, document.write. We will use document.write here to print on the page, document.write. and I will write a, or you can write c, and let's print the document. And let me reload this, control R. Here you can see the output 99.3. even you can also a variable a, and let's reload this, and here you can see, and also check variable b. So make sure that you subscribe my YouTube channel so you guys can get new updates. Here you can see. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I will use console. Now I will write in console, not in the document. So what I will do, I will write console.log, and after that here you have to write, for example, you want to write your name, so I will choose b1, and I will reload this and click inspect, and you have to go here. Here you can see JavaScript, and even you can also don't comment this if you don't want. Here you can see, you will see in both. Here you can see JavaScript and same thing, same output, and here you can make a, and here you can make b. So yeah, and output is 99, and JavaScript, just remove this. Okay,
so guys, now we are going to learn the concept of variables in JavaScript. So what are variables? In simple words, let me make a new file here, variable.javascript, variable.js, and also I will make a new file of HTML, variable.html, and we will use the same process. So here we have to connect our JavaScript. Simply write your JavaScript name, variable.js, simply. Okay, fine. Okay, now just click on variable.js and make some space here, and now I will zoom it so you guys can see it clearly. Okay, now what are variables? Variables in JS, in simple words, variables are used to store the values. This is the most simple line to learn about variables, that what are variables and why they are used. Variables are used to store the values. Now this is the most simple line to learn about variables. Okay, now how to use variables? Simply use the keyword variable price is equal to one. Keyword variable price is equal to one, and after the price of a product one is equal to 100, or even you can use 400, 104, whatever you can use. And I will add a comment here, variable one, and after that variable price 2 is equal to 108, and sorry, I will, okay, fine now, and here we will use variable 2. Okay, now variable 3, variable price 3 is equal to price 1 plus price 2. Okay, fine. Now we are going to print it. We are going to print it on the page. So we will use document.write, and after that we will also print it on the console. So we will use price 3. Price, what is price 3? Price 3 is the price 1 plus price 2. So let's check it output, and I'm just going to variable. Here you can see, and here you can check its output, 12, 212 is the sum of 104 plus 108. And after that, if you want to print it out on console.log, you can also use the console. Let me, okay, simply write console.log, and here you have to write price 3. Okay, now let me check its output. Here is variable, and here you have to click on console, and here you can see its output. Let me zoom it for you. Here you can see 212, and now what we have to do, so this is the method to use variable in JavaScript. So guys, now let's learn about the operators in JavaScript. So what are operators? So I'm not going to create a new file here in this, so I will use the index file here. I'll comment it out, a control a, and not here, control A and control slash. Okay, fine. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to use operators in JavaScript. So what are operators and how to use operators? Simply let me write something here. So I will teach you the basic types of operators. So let me comment it here, operators in JS. Okay, now the first one is arithmetic operator. What is arithmetic operator? In arithmetic operator we use operators. Okay, now in arithmetic operator there is plus minus, multiply and divide. These are arithmetic operators. So how to use it? Simply I will use a variable. Everything is commented out. Okay, now variable A is equal to 10 and variable b is equal to 20. Now we have to find out, is it working? Our arithmetic operator is working. So we will use console.log. Even you can use in document.write, but right now I'm going to use in console.log. So console.log, the sum is and a comma here. I will use a plus b. Okay, now a semicolon. I'm going to copy and pasting it so it will save our some time. Control v here. Okay, now not sum, a here will be subtract and here we will use multiply and here is div, and here we will use our symbols of minus, divide, multiply and divide. Okay, let's check its output, and here I have to open my index. Okay, now let's check it in the console section, and here you can see the sum of a plus b is 30 and the subtract is minus 10 and multiply is 200 and divide is 0.5. okay, this is the arithmetic operator. So there is another one, and not another one, there is many. So I'm just going to teach you two. So these are the basics. So you will learn the basics of operators in JavaScript. So this one is the first, and arithmetic operator and the assignment operator. Assignment operator is nothing. Okay, in assignment operator we assign the values. This is work or assignment operator. So here I'm going to do one thing, is that variable, I will create a new variable and I will give it to name a variable c. Variable c is equal to, I will equal it to variable a. Okay, simply you have to write a, and now let's check it out. First of all you have to console it, console.log, and you have to print in console.log, and let's check it output, log c and a semicolon here. Okay, now let's check it output, and here is my index. Okay, simply click on index and click on right button of mouse and inspect. So here you can click on console, and it show us 2 is 10 because we assign here c is equal to 1 and we did console.log and c. So this is the basic concept of operators in JavaScript. So now what we are going to do, learn our next thing in JavaScript. So guys, now we are going to learn the concept of comparison operator in JavaScript. So first of all, we have to create a new file here, and I'm going to name it as comparison.html, and I will create also a new file here, a file of js comparison, checking my spellings, comparison.js. fine. Now what we have to do, I'm just going to repeat, not in JS, sorry. sorry for this. In HTML, okay, just press shift and exclamation mark, you will see the header files. And now first of all, we have to connect our HTML comparison.html to comparison.js. So you have to write the name of your JS file here, so you can check, so you can connect your HTML to JS. So fine, we connected our HTML to JS. So now we are going to start our coding here. And first of all, let me cut this from the notification bar or from the bar. Okay, and now let me comment here and let me make some space here so you guys can see it clearly. Comparison operators in JavaScript in JS. Fine. Now what does I'm going to do? I will make a multiple comment here so you guys can, I mean, let me show you the comparison operators in JS and multiple line comment here. And equal to not equal to less than greater than equal to less than equal to and less than greater than sorry here less than less than and we are going to close our multiple statement, multi-line statement. And here you can see these are our comparison operators in JS. So now what I'm going to do, so let's start our let's do with any example. So first of all, we have to declare any variable. Variable A is equal to you can write anything like 20 and variable B is equal to 35 or whatever you want. So variable A and variable B, and now we are going to write console.log, console.log, and sorry for static. And here you have to write your comparisons like A equal to B and semicolon. Don't forget the semicolon. Let me copy paste it so we can save our some time here. So let me paste it here. Okay, fine. Now write your all of your comparison operators, not equal to, greater than equal to, here greater than, here less than, and here simple greater than, and here less than. Fine, a less than, fine. Now what I'm going to do, so let me check our let's check our output. Is this is our comparison operator is working in JS. So this is comparison, and let me click on inspect using right button on mouse and click on console here. A console, fine. Here you can see false, true, false, true, true, false, because first one is false because 20 is not equal to 35, and the second one is true because a first one is not equal to B, a not equal to B, and a then false, a not greater than, and then true, then false, then true. Here you can see this is how comparison operator work in JavaScript. And let's learn something new in a operator. So what does I'm going to do, let me comment all of statements in JS. So now what I'm going to do, now we are going to run if statement, if or if else statement, if or elif, else if statement or conditions in JS. Fine. Now first of all, we have to declare a variable here, and variable, now variable name of the variable is will be age, and age equal to 20 or whatever you want, like 30, 20, 25. It depends on you, on your program, what kind of program you want from yourself. Okay, now variable age equal to 20, and we are going to apply our condition if age in round brackets, we will write age here, if age, and if age greater than 20, and a semicolon here, sorry, not semicolon, a delimiters here. Now write console.log. We are going to print in console, console.log. You can write anything like that. You can go for you can go outside, or you can go outside and can party with your friends, or whatever you want to write, like party with friends, or you can write whatever you want. Else you can, else we also am going to use else here, and else you can add console.log, sorry, console.log here. fine now around brackets around log round brackets here. Now we are going to write you cannot go outside because you are not eligible, you are not 20, whatever you want. So and simply write you cannot go, simply click on inspect, and after that you can see where is my output. It's not showing here. You can see you cannot go outside. So our program is running well. This is our first program of if condition. So you can also see that when I change the age, and you can see, okay, I just forgot one thing, equal to, and now we are going to learn a else if condition or if else condition. Now variable age is equal to 20, same procedure, age greater than equal to 20 here, and if age equal to greater than equal to 20, and delimiters here, and after that you have to write in console.log, and in console.log you have to we are going to use the same statement, like you can go with your friends, or if you want to change for your practice you can also change, but right now I'm just going to copy pasting it. I made a mistake here, and let's remove this. Okay, fine, our program is fine. Now what I'm going to do, we are also using here else if condition, so let me reduce so you guys can see. Okay, fine, let's else if and a delimiter here, else if, sorry, I just made a mistake here, I just forgot round brackets and condition, else if age, and in age less than 20, and now in delimiters you have to write console.log you cannot go outside, simple as we learned before in if statement. Now we are writing in else if statement. You can also make your examples, your own example, but I am just using a random example as you can see. Now I'm just using another else if condition. Now I don't know what to write here. Okay, you can write first of all age, what you have to what does write not equal to 20. Okay, age not equal to 20, this is also a condition. Okay, now use a delimiter here, simply console.log, and in console.log you have also have to write that you cannot go, or you can write depends on your condition, that what kind of condition you are using. Like if you are not 20, equal to 20, it's mean you are a kid, or you are not able to go outside, you are not able to go outside, or simply go. Okay, now you after that you can also use else condition, console.log here, fine. Now what you have to do is simply you can also write that stay home, like stay at home, fine. So let me show you our program. Okay, it's showing you can go outside and can party with friends because our age is greater than equal to 20 as we used in our program. You can see, let me change the value, it will show the same answer here. You can see okay, now let's reduce it, and it will say you cannot go outside because you are not able to, because you are kid. Okay, this is our else if condition in JavaScript. So I may hope that you guys learn a lot of things in this video. So now what we are going to do now, okay guys, now we are going to learn the concept of arrays, loops, and another thing that we will learn is that objects. I just forgot about objects in the start, so I will also teach you objects. So first of all, we have to create a new file. You can also use the previous one. So I am just going to name it as array.js, or you can name it whatever you want. So First of all, we have to repeat the same process here, array.html, like, and after that we have to connect our HTML to JS. Now, how to connect? Simply write script and src. Now, name of your JS file. What is the name of your JS file? Is like the name of my JS file is array.js, so it will be connected to my JS. So my HTML is connected to JS. So now let's write. The codes of our JS in a separate file or externally. So let's comment here and arrays in JavaScript or arrays in simply arrays in JS or whatever you want to write. And let me make some space and let me zoom it for you so you guys can see it clearly. So first of all, we have to create a variable. And variable name, this is array, and variable name, or this is the syntax of array, variable name and square brackets. Okay, variable name. Okay, you can also name it as books or whatever you want. And okay, variable, or simply we are going to choose num. Variables num, you can also give it name as num or whatever you want, like now variable array. So this is simple, variable array is equal to square bracket, and now you have to write your array here, atoms of array. Okay, now 10 12 20 30 40 and comma 50 60 60 and 70, here 80 90. If you want further, you can also write further. I'm not going to. You don't miss the semicolon here. Okay, now we have to write console.log here. We will print this in console, and now write the name of the array, which is array. So just open array and inspect here. You can see console. Okay, look at this is the array, our array. Here you can see, and 0 to 8, and this is the, because the index is 0, and index in JavaScript start from 0, so that's why it's 8 number, 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Fine. Okay, now we can also add for loop here. For I is equal to 0 and I greater than, sorry, I less than array, and the length of the array dot length, and I plus plus here some semicolon, and I plus plus, I think here we have to add a semicolon. Oh, sorry, not a semicolon, we have to add delimiters here, our curly braces, you can also call it delimiters, and console.log here. In console.log you have to write the name of a name, like I think I made a mistake. Let me remove the I first and write array and a square bracket and write I here. Okay, fine. Let's so this is a way to you can also use loop. So it's a loop in array. So this is a method, so you can see that here, you can see in this console. Okay, you can also use a while loop in the array. Okay, first we use I, and now we are going to use j. What is let? Why we use the word let? Because let is a keyword, is a kind of keyword in JS. And now while, here we are going to use a condition, while, and here first of all we have to write array dot length, okay, I just forgot j less than array dot length. Okay, fine. Now okay, now what we have to do, add a delimiter here, and after that console.log, and in console.log you have to add a same like this console.log array and j, array and square bracket and j here. Fine. Now add a semicolon here. So if you will run this code as it without adding without j plus plus, your program will be infinite, so don't forget this and write j plus plus. So this is also a method to write while loop in our JS. So you can use this method to use JS. So now what we are going to do, okay, you can also use, Okay, now this is the method to learn while loop. So you guys learn a lot of things now. Okay, now what I'm going to do, you have to write, okay, this is 10, 20. Let me check my output. Let me check my question here. I think I made a mistake here. Okay, I think everything is okay with our program. I was just worried about this. Okay, now let's learn about objects in JS. Our for loop and while loop is working almost perfectly in this. So let me comment out first of all the console.log and fine. Now console.log array, so it will not affect my program. Okay, now fine. Okay, oh, now objects in JS. Now what are objects? First of all, we have to create a variable here. Variable, like you can also create a variable of a person, like variable person or variable person information, person information, fine. And a delimiter here. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to add the information of the person, like first name and equal to first name equal to, and in double quotation we have to write its name, like two brothers, like Joe, Doe, or whatever you want, like Harry, Carrie, Larry. You can add whatever you want. I'm just adding a random names here. Second name is equal to Doe, so I just forgot name. It's showing me an a kind of error. Let me add semicolon here. Is my code working right? No, it's still showing me error. So I think I just made a mistake here. I just forgot that we have use colon in objects, not the equal to sign here, and also not semicolon. We have to add, first of all, let add me here a colon. Now fine, and a simple comma here, fine. So still it's showing me error. Let me see where is my error. I added colon. Okay, variable person information. Okay, here is my error. I'm just forgot to add equal to here. So now what I'm going to do here, you can see now age equal to, age here. I will add here like age colon 20 comma, fine. Now okay, here you can add anything else about a person information, whatever you can, like its address, its information, whatever you want. Okay, now we have to add console, don't forget a semicolon. Now console.log and the name of the variable, like person information. So this is the look. I will also create a new let me comment here, objects in JS, and okay, fine. Okay, I will also create a new object here, like this object will be a marks object. So then we will see both input of the output of the both objects. So variable, may variable, you can name the variable marks or whatever you want, equal to delimiters here. And now you can give the names like Harry, Carrie, Larry, three brothers or two brothers or whatever you want to name them. Marks is equal to, not equal to, sorry, I just forgot, marks colon 100 and comma. And here you can also add the other names like Carrie colon, and marks will be 900 out of 100. Harry got full marks and Carrie got 90 marks, and Larry got 95 marks, or whatever you want. You can choose, it all depends on you. And write console.log marks, and let me check out my output. Simply click on inspect and click on console. Okay, click on console. Here you can see this is my object first and this is my object second, and this it's showing me it's firstly showing it's me age, and then showing me my first age name and second name. So same problem in the second. Let me run this again. So here you can see, okay, let me remove the comment here, the marks. Okay, let's check it again. Here you can see, now here you can see this is the output of our object. Here you can see first name Joe, second name Do, and age 20. Here you can see, and this is the method and to use objects in our JavaScript. So I may hope that guys you have learned a lot of things in JavaScript. So if you like, so please don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and please share it with your friends so they can also get benefit from these tutorials. And make sure that you have subscribed my YouTube channel and press the bell icon so you can get all the new videos that I will upload on my YouTube channel.